Let's dive deep. How do you do a full life cycle use case?
Full life cycle use case starts with the pre-acquisition. How do they know they have a problem? And will they acknowledge that problem? And then will they look for solutions for that problem? So that's very, very important, because the best product doesn't always win. It's the best product that the customer knows about. So then we get to the pre-acquisition. The acquisition is they get the product, they use it, they get some value. Then the post-acquisition is, okay, now how do they pay for it? How do they buy more? How do they tell other people about it? So we're trying to get this full loop going in here in the full life cycle, because that's what's going to generate a great business. We want to get into that virtuous cycle. Because remember, with our target customers, they have a similar product, it's a similar sales cycle, and they have word of mouth. We want to recognize the importance of word of mouth, and we want to accelerate that. We want to promote that amongst our customers. And that's why a full life cycle use case with those three parts is so important. Pre-acquisition, you know, use, and then post-acquisition.
So the goal, once you've produced your full life cycle use case, you then go and take it to your persona.
Yes, absolutely. You don't do this life cycle by yourself sitting in a room. You might make a first draft at it. You might not even make a first draft. You might just go ask those fundamental questions to your persona, and then you iterate with your persona as much as possible. That will be your first draft of the use case. And then you're going to go and ask other people to make sure that that's not a one-off.
I'd like to anticipate a problem that might happen in this process. By this time, you will have developed a relationship with your persona. Presumably, the persona likes you, it is mutual, and the persona begins to develop a commitment bias.
Yes. I mean, one of the worst people you can go out to get primary market research is your parents, because they're not going to give you honest feedback. They're too emotionally connected to you. On the other hand, you can't go out and ask someone off the street, because they're not going to be honest with you. So there's this balance in your persona when you're getting feedback on the full life cycle use case or other things. You want them to be objective, but you want them to be open and honest with you. And sometimes a persona will be good for a set period of time, and then they might not be good because they become more emotionally attached to you.
What should you do if you present your full life cycle use case to your persona and the persona reacts negatively?
If the persona just agrees with everything you say, then I would worry about whether you're getting good feedback, because you're not going to get it right the first time. So the persona gives you negative feedback, then you must listen to that. You know, in the search for truth, consistency must come in second. You can't be too prideful about what it is that you've done. We're in inquiry mode. That's very, very important. The final arbiter of what's correct and what's not is a customer.
You teach about full life cycle use case in the campus version of this course. I took that course, loved it, that's why I'm here. And I wonder, what are the common pitfalls that you see among students who carry out their full life cycle use case?
The biggest problem is that pre-acquisition stage. That's where people fall down. They don't realize that you have to get the attention of the end user. The biggest competitor that you face as an entrepreneur is the do-nothing option. That is, they don't do anything, because people generally don't like to change. So you have to get out there and find out, how can we activate our end user to want to buy a product and then make that product be our product? The second part is they forget the back end of it. Now the question is, how do they pay you for it? It's very important to know, do they pay me right away? Do I get paid later? Do I get paid through somebody else? Because if you don't have that cash flow, and the cash flow is 60 days later than you thought, that can be very, very dangerous for a startup. It can be fatal, in fact. And then the question is, stay with it. You know, as you say in sports, run through the tape. Once they've used it and they're happy, then figure out how they're going to buy more, and then how they're going to tell other people about your product. Because the best customer, the cheapest customer for you, is the customer you already have. If you can sell them more systems or more software, more features, whatever it is, that's the best customer for you. And if you can make them very happy and they tell 7 other people, 10 other people, those are the best leads you can get, because your best salesperson is not someone that you hire. Your best salesperson is a happy customer that will tell other people about it.
Bill, as an entrepreneur, you are often blazing completely new trails. So you can't really compare yourself to others. at the same time, how do you know that you've done a good job on your full lifecycle use case?
Well, you got to do the best you can. And if you've completed the step, you've done a good job. You can't worry whether you've got it all right the first time, because I've seen this done hundreds of times, thousands of times, and it's never right the first time. But what you do is you get started in the journey. You start with the best possible use case you can, working with your persona. But much like your persona and your product, it's an iterative process that will get better over time. Look, we just figured out who our customer is. Now we're starting to work on why our customer is going to get it. And so in this case, it's just important we do a first pass at this and get started. It'll get better over time. As Amelia Earhart said, the hardest part is getting started. After that, it's just perseverance.